Okay, so we are back with another location for all you horror nerds out there. We are at the car closing door where a 1799 murder has been taking place. And not only did the 1799 murder have taken place, the murderer himself was actually acquitted and had actually had to leave the city because everyone considered himself guilty. So this location was actually considered one of the most popular destinations upon request because it's not easily accessible and was considered one of the most haunted places of all time. Rumor has it that there is a ghost, possibly the victim herself. Her name is Dan. Amola Dan, I believe, if I pronounce the name right. Who happened to be the victim herself. Haunting the well. A steel well, by the way. Which happened to be underneath the store. And it's now known today as the Manhattan Motor Well. I'm LK the Horror Nerd, and this is the ultimate Horror Nerd experience trip in New York City. Stay tuned, we got more to tell you. Hi. So, I'm LK the Horror Nerd, and this is the guy who works here at the famous Dakota. So, this is the movie where they made a really famous movie called Rosemary's Baby. So, can you confirm for me where this is the actual location where they actually made Rosemary's Baby?
I really don't know. I didn't see the movie.
Oh, you never seen the movie?
No, I never seen the movie.
So, what's all of it for then?
What is this?
Yeah, the dungeon and everything.
That's so people don't come in. It's a private building.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's a residential
building. Okay. Well, I heard that this is a really famous location.
Yeah, yeah.
They made movies like Vanilla Sky and then the horror movie Rosemary's Baby.
Correct.
Which came out in 1958. So, I can't believe you've never seen the movie. You should look it up.
I know, I am.
Okay,
I think I
cool.
So many people talk about it.
Alright, well, this is Delkay the Horror Nerd at the Dakota in New York City. But hey, this is the true history, alright? So based on the history, the Dakota was actually a very famous location where actually two movies had been known to be filmed here, although there might have been other locations. However, filming had not been allowed on this block, but the actor can be seen and come across Vanilla Sky, where Tom Cruise was in, and Cameron Diaz. Also, like I say, considering I'm a horror nerd, Rosemary's Baby was actually filmed here and came out in 1968. And a lot of famous actors and actresses were here. So it's pretty cool to see a lot of great things that was filmed here. So it's very interesting to see that. But I can't believe that guy never seen a film though. I've had actually seen a film, but it's pretty cool. Anyway, this is Del Curry, the Horror Nerd, done now. Until next time, and we will see you for more on the ultimate Horror Nerd Experience trip into New York City. What do you think? Come here a little closer. So, this is a park and a museum. Or is it? Come here a little closer. See that sign right there? Now you see that sign right here? So come here a little bit closer. The Morris-Jumel Mansion, I tell you, and restoration accessibility project. Or is it? Well, on this journey, we are concluding, well, not just yet, because we got another location to go to. We are concluding so far that this is actually a haunted place, which you are not granted a tour yet because you have to reserve in advance. This place was actually haunted by the Madam Bird, who happened to be formerly married to Aaron Burr during the American Revolutionary War. Now, rumor had it that the great Aaron Burr, although we're not going to really call him Aaron Burr because the man might have been genocidal during the war, who knows? Whitewash history, all we know. The story is that there is a possibility that the Madam Bird might have been a murderer. I feel chill, murderer. But we don't know the whole story. because, again, there has been documents, there's been stories, there's been rumors from over the years. But if you want to find out more, you're going to have to come back next time. When I come back here, very, very soon. Until then, I will see you at the next location on my ultimate HorrorNerd Experience into New York City. We're going to learn a lot about the history. But this history right here is so haunting that you could probably hear the creepy little sound on the very wall inside the building. And you could probably hear the Madden Bird screaming at children to shut up! Just backing up like this is creepy. We are walking through the pipe, which had been reserved during the American Revolutionary War. And this here happens to be one of the oldest clocks in New York City. But the history is not tragic. It's violent. Very, very violent. Just how violent is the history? Yeah, figure that. You think bodies are buried down there?
Most definitely, yes.
I have my lovely addicted with me, Lady Rain Live from Quit. Oh, now that's creepy. What the fuck happened here? Are you serious right now?
Why not?
I don't want to be disturbing no ghost. That's not going on my fucking karma. Although I would not be surprised if we found a dead body or not.
Exactly.
This is creepier than the Blair Witch Project.
At night it's worse.
And it's in New York fucking city! Although they did not film Strange Shit in New York City. They did not do that. Don't touch me that, come on. You had to say it, lady, you had to touch me that, really?
I did.
Oh man, this is so creepy.